Hi, I'm Erica Gamet with InDesign Secrets. In this video, I'm going to show you a quick way to italicize text that's currently inside quotation marks. And I'm going to show you how to automate that process using the Find Change dialog box and the power of GREP. Now, before you get too scared, I'm going to show you that GREP really isn't that scary and that it can also make your job much easier. In this paragraph, we have some quoted text that should be in italics. So let's go to the Find Change dialog box using Command or Control F, and we're going to click on the GREP tab and enter what we're looking for in the Find What field. Now with GREP, we don't need to know specific text like we would inside the Text tab, just the type of text we're looking for. In this case, we know that we're looking for some opening quotes, followed by some text, followed by closing quotes. InDesign has a secret menu where the GREP expressions are hidden. It's over here under the at symbol. So we're going to click on that. And in our case, we're looking for some quotes. So we're going to choose quotation marks and choose double left quotation marks. And it puts in the GREP expression for double left quotation marks. Next, we know that we're looking for some text, but we don't know exactly what that text is going to be. So we're going to use a wildcard to express any character. So back over to the secret menu, wildcards, any character. And the GREP expression for that is just a simple period. Now we need to tell it that there are a lot of characters, and we don't know how many. So we go back to the secret menu, under repeat, and choose one or more times. That gives us a little plus. I like to call period plus stuff that we're looking for. Lastly, we need to look for our closing quotes, back to the secret menu, back under the quotation marks, double right quotation marks. And we can see what the symbol for that is as well. One last thing we have to do is to break this expression into groups, because we're going to get rid of some groups, the quotation marks, and we're going to style another group, the text that we want italicized. So we have to set these groups off using parentheses. So group 1, group 2, and group 3. So I'm just going to put parentheses around each group, make sure I get both parts of that expression in there, followed by some text one or more times, followed by that closing quotation mark. Now you can actually add the parentheses as you're putting the expressions in, which is actually a little easier. All right, so let's do a search on the expression we just built. So I'm going to make sure I'm only searching by this story. I have this story selected, and I'm going to say find next. And there it is. It found our quoted text, and it's ready to style it for us. Perfect. Now in the change to field is where we tell it what out of the previous expression we want to keep. Well, we only want group number 2, the text that's in the middle of these quotes. So in the change to field, we're going to go over to this secret menu. We're going to choose found and then found 2, which means group number 2. And that gives us a $2, which is just GREP for the second group. So that returns the text in the middle of the quotes, but it also gets rid of the quotes because we didn't ask for groups 1 and 3. Lastly, we need to italicize the results. So we choose our italic character style from the change format section. We're going to click in the box here, go up to our character style, choose a pre-made one or create one on the fly, and say OK. So now when I say change all, it says it made one replacement and it italicized the text and also removed the quotes from around that text. Now you'll need to take an extra step if you have multiple instances in the same paragraph. For instance, I have two pieces here that are in quotes that need to be italicized. If I choose this frame and make sure I'm only searching by story again and say change all, you notice it went ahead and italicized everything from the first quote to the last quote. GREP is greedy in that way. It wants to grab everything within a paragraph. I'm going to undo that and change my expression so that it finds one instance, changes it, and then moves on. So to do that, I'm going to go back into my expression, and I'm going to come in right here, right after that find stuff expression, and enter a question mark. And that basically tells it shortest match. Now it will find the first instance, move on, and then find the next. So let's check that out. I say find next, find next. Then I can simply click change all, and it italicizes those two titles separately. Well, I certainly hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and to subscribe to our monthly publication, InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.